why, who, what, when, and where.
Out here with the Queens of Chaos. As soon as I kicked Woodley's door in, he went running for the foothills like the little bitch he is.
They're gonna ask to fight Bisping because George don't want to fight me.
What'd you say?
They're gonna ask to fight Bisping because George doesn't want to fight me.
Listen, the Bisping ship has sailed.
This was a smart fight. You won this fight, clearly. But the record was broken for the least amount of strikes thrown in any fight.
Listen, it's easy to say a win is a win. But when you get booed out of an arena, it means people don't want to watch you fight.
Every time Tyron Woodley opens his mouth, he shoots himself in the foot.
Oh! Oh! Whoa! Shoot yourself in the foot. What did he say to you afterwards?
Oh, I haven't spoken to him yet. Did he already come in here?
No.
He left.
I don't have no smoke with Dana, to be honest.
Beat your ass in real life. Beat your ass on TV. Nigga, I'll beat your ass with some beef shit. Beat your ass on GP. Pull up on that sneak tip. Niggas run when they...
I see what's going on. Tyrone's doing very well and seems very dramatic.
Nah, I hadn't talked to him. Now your eyes fucking popping out, you
seeing shit in 3D. No drama. We get in, we get out. We put people to sleep, no drama. Beat your ass.
What happens next? I mean, everybody's pointing to Colby Covington saying that's the fight they want to see. Is that the fight you want? I'll beat your ass.
How would you characterize your relationship with Dana these days?
Baby, can't you see?
Hey, listen, going out and saying mean things doesn't mean much. Beating Damian Maia does.
I'm here with the winner and new interim welterweight champion, Colby Covington.
There's no escape.
You can't run, you can't hide no more, Tyron Woodley. I'm coming for you.
That was a statement open for interpretation. My interpretation, Ariel, yes. I think we got a fight.
I was fighting him because he was the next up the line. But when I'm faced with a line that want to take my belt, it's game time.
Tomorrow night, I'm getting 10 pounds of gold, and then I'm bringing it to Dana. I'm bringing it to Donald Trump like a real champion should.
Outstanding wow. Championship fight between Colby Covington.
That is hilarious. He actually did it.
And prove that you're not just talking in there.
No one can stop my will, Joe. No one can go 25 minutes with here.
Taking what's rightfully mine, the UFC welterweight title. There's nothing you can do to stop it.
And secondly, Joe, Tyron Woodley, you're a freaking coward. Why'd you let this little filthy animal take this ass whooping tonight? This is supposed to be you.
My single, I'll Beat Your Ass, is coming out next week.
Let's go, man.
I fought my fucking life for this belt. I put everything for this belt. He want to come and get it. Everybody think they want something until they lock that octagon. He gonna see.
Now he's got Tyron so mad. Tyron wants to fucking kill him.
Tyron, whoa, you want to end his career?
I want to end his life.
He did interviews with people. He told them, don't bring up Colby's name.
Brazil, you're a dog! All you filthy animals suck! I got one thing to say! Tyron Woodley, I'm coming for you! If you don't answer the front door,
Colby. Do you feel like people are forgetting that you're actually a very skilled fighter because you come up with things like that?
We ain't translating tonight, baby. All you need to know is bring me my belt. Where you at, Tyron Woodley?
Colby Covington, my God.
And explain what's going on with this water bottle. Does that say nerd tears on side?
Yeah, this does say nerd tears. All the people out there that doubted me, all the nerds and virgins, which is mostly my haters.
Well, people try to pick fights or don't want to fight this guy. I don't play that though. Man, if you want to play those games here, you better win every fight, because I'll cut you.
Good morning, Dallas. Hi, we're here with Brendan Shaw from the UFO.
We got the number one contendership fight this weekend. Daryl the Doughboy versus Tyquell Woodley.
He just got his fight back.
This guy had a chance. You know, he had a chance to fight me last December. He let Darren Till go out there and take his whooping for him.
Dana White's mentioned that Colby would potentially be next. Is that a fight that you'd be excited about?
I'm past due for my title shot. It's time for me to claim my throne.
Let me say this. I'm here to stay. It's the Woodley Way division.
This is the real world championship. If Tyron Woodley has something to say about it, he can come see me.
The second he won that belt, I said, let's come get this smoke. He got quiet. I know I'm the best in the world. I know my opponent can't deal with the amount of power, speed, aggression, agility that I bring to the table. I am a samurai.
Tyron Woodley ducked me for a reason. He didn't want to fight me.
Dude, he shut all that Darren Till hype up quick.
Let's go over some of the numbers and some of the facts about him. He has KO'd Jay Huron, Josh Koscheck, and Robbie Lawler. He TKO'd Carlos Condit.
What they don't know is the bullshit, the drama, the guns, the armor, the city, the farmer, the babies, the mama, the problems, the things we use to solve them. Yonkers, the Bronx, Brooklyn, Harlem. Somebody stop, please. Somebody come and get me. What? Little did I know that the law was riding with me. The dark, the light, my heart, the fight, the wrong, the right, it's gone.
The future is hard. The present and the past is quite knowable. What does Tyron Woodley need to do now to get corporate backing?
Always will stand for the national anthem.
Just pop, pop, constant attack.
Breaking news tonight from the White House. President Trump calling an audible, canceling tomorrow's scheduled visit by the NFL Super Bowl champion Philadelphia Eagles.
I'm gonna do what a real American should do. I'm bringing this belt to the White House.
Essentially disinvites the Super Bowl champion Philadelphia Eagles.
Oh, how do you feel about the president disinviting a football team to the White House?
Colby, man, you were incredibly impressive.
You fought a world champion, a real world-class fighter.
here.
Did the Eagles overdo it? Really overdo it?
Is the president above the law?
He insists that they proudly stand for the national anthem.
You said you always had faith in your cardio. You had pressure. You had...
Dude, this kid's cardio is insane.
I have the best cardio in the world. Every time I train with everybody, literally they're done in two rounds.
Beating Maya the way he beat Maya, everybody right. had to open their eyes up and go, huh?
I say the most important thing is not... politics.
The most impressive thing was the pace he put on him, because Dos Anjos is known for his cardio.
He said he wants to take that belt to the White House. Will you put in a call to your buddy Trump and try to make that happen?
He wants to take, yeah. Yeah, I can make that happen.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I did everything I said I was going to do. I told everybody I was going to make the welterweight division great again, and now I'm going to celebrate how a real American should celebrate winning a world title, and that's going to the White House to see Mr. Donald Trump put this on his desk. Unlike the Philadelphia Eagles disrespecting our country's flag by kneeling for the national anthem.
How do you anticipate the build-up to a fight with Covington if that happens next?
His Instagram page was 90% me.
My God.
You know, it's just me being me, man. I have no emotions, no feelings. I don't care what people think of me.
Him and Tyron Woodley's gonna be crazy.
Are you really getting upset over this?
Yes, I'm getting upset. Can't you tell?
Because of what I said?
Not because of what you said, but because of how you said it.
Do you really want to fight about this right here?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's party time! Let's go! This is the main event!
Whoever they put in front of me, we're going to beat him up. I'm the best welterweight of all time.
And he backs up, and then he tries to explode with one shot.
Make some noise, ladies and gentlemen. Colby Chaos Covington. This is my division now.
It's called the Boo Boo Bell. It's one bell, and it's one champion.
How you feel?
Like a champ.
How you feel?
Let's
go! Don't miss it. Let's go.
Now.
Why, who, what, when, and where. But of the who, what, when, and where, I would offer to you the most important in storytelling, in promoting, is the why.